Well, this is Robert Corizon, coming to you live from outside the headquarters of the NWO Eagle. The world leaders are now figuring out how or they're going to tally up the spoils and debby them out to each other.
Redress.
Or what's happening at this very moment is the world leaders have come together, realizing that only 1.6 billion people still remain. They will have a workforce of 1.5 billion to take care of the 100 million of the elites. Now, of the elites, there will only be 50 super elite. All diseases organized known to be detrimental to mankind of the past 21 centuries have now been eradicated. It has now been discovered and revealed that most of the strangest diseases were caused by the governments to map out their agenda. The agenda they labeled as Agenda 21. As the 21st century came to an end, nobody was the wiser. Nobody mentioned this. Nobody announced this. And so now, we hail a new dawn, a new era of supremacy and organized population control. This is Robert Corizon coming to you live from WMCVJ Organization.
Ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies and gents. No, this video is not to talk about the people who supposedly went to the moon and blah, 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 blah. That's just the backdrop. We just wanted to invite all of you along with Freddie Jackson here. We're going to try to shake some things down because there's a need for a little bit of an understanding. The first thing we're going to talk about is the event coming up next weekend. This is Saturday, November the 3rd, I believe. And the event is Saturday, November 10th and Sunday, November 11th. That event will be going on for, how many days? 2 days! From 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. People are saying, do you have an itinerary? Go back and look at the November 11th, 2012 video, and you will see the itinerary. There is no need to update that because that's exactly what we're going to be talking about. Do you have the times you're going to be talking about this information? That will be forthcoming as we have the times, but we are going to be needing to update that information because as the week has progressed, we've actually come up with new information. Now, let's finish talking about the seminar before I go into talking about the interesting things we have been figuring out lately that we will go over in more detail during the event. There will be no food or drinks allowed inside the conference room area. If you bring food and drinks, they're going to charge me. And if you were to do that, I will make sure that when you're kicked out of the facility, you understand how much I appreciated you. Because the amount that they are charging is unreasonable. But I cannot do anything about that. So, no food and drinks. Another news flash! We will be allowing, as of now, recording of the event. Okay, I've decided I'm going to let you all record it because I'm not one to hide information from people. However, there is certain information I will not be disseminating to the public. But we realize that it wouldn't be fair to you if you were there just taking notes and would not have a way of recalling anything. So we will be allowing recordings. No, the seminar will not be placed on the internet. And you will agree, not conditionally, but you will agree that if we allow you to record this event, that you will not disseminate it to the general population or anyone else that it was for your review only, and we will get rid of all of that. Well, what if I listen to it and somebody overhears it? No, you will agree that you will do it in the privacy of your own home, within the private viewing of your own person only. You see, we won't give you any loopholes. People are always looking for them loopholes. They find a loophole and they just jump in, and it's too small for them, so they expand it and expand it and expand it to the point where it's no longer a hole. It's a complete wormhole gateway to the galaxies. So we're not going to allow that, okay?
Okay, let's talk about the information that's going to help some of you doing the closed checking account method.
You know, I've been doing the closed checking account method since 1915, and it's always worked for me, and I ain't never had a problem.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, what's happening is many of you guys are sending out instruments.
Yes, that's right. You're sending out instruments.
And they're not returning them, or they're returning them with stamps and marks and writing on it. They're not allowed to deface your instruments. Your property?
Our property? How is that our property?
That's exactly what the banks are saying. How is it your property? Well, technically, it's not your property. You surrendered it to someone else. So it becomes their property. Unless you do what they do. Give me a second to see if I can pull out a letter. I have a letter here from an attorney, because I was working on somebody's credit. Well, it is the same thing. But this is from one of the... What's the name of those? One of the mortgage companies, servicers. And this is regarding somebody's particular mortgage. Now, those whose mortgages I'm working on, some of you have told me about your dire situations. You know, you can't afford this, you can't afford that, and you wish to make some payment arrangements and all that. And I've been more than reasonable. I allowed and permitted people to do that, but after 2 months, not a single person has paid the difference of what they were required to contribute originally. Not a single person. And I'm beginning to think that they think that it's okay, that they'll let me go through the whole process and then they will take care of the remainder. Ladies and gentlemen, at no time now or in the future will I ever threaten to stop the process with anyone, because I operate in good faith. I am a man of my word. If I say I'm going to do something, I do the best I can to accomplish it. There was one gentleman that we sent out some paperwork and there were a couple of mistakes and we had to correct those. And so we resent the paperwork out. There are a couple of people whom their foreclosures were a lot closer than originally announced. One person, we accepted his foreclosure because it was closer. We said we would extend courtesy and help him. But at no time, if you listen to the video, did I ever tell anyone that I would handle lawsuits. I never agreed to that, because as I've always stated, lawsuits take on a different form. There's a lot more work goes into that. We have to respond. And we have to respond according to what's presented by the court or by the defendants or by the plaintiffs or whomever it is. And we cannot be there for you in court, so it takes a lot of coaching. But we've decided to help these people nonetheless. They didn't pay any difference. There was no higher contribution required or nothing, because I'm a man of my word. And it's not that I feel sorry for people. I do feel for the plight, circumstances, and situation people are in. And I said peoples, not you people, like Ross Perot. But a lot of people are taking advantage of that. I get emails telling people, do not ask me any more questions. And then all of a sudden, they want to go around the internet typing information about me saying that he doesn't answer questions. Interesting. When I'm asking no questions of anyone, but I'm getting questions every single email. Every single email, someone's asking one question or another, or
They're sending me links telling me to check this link out, but they're not even explaining why I should be checking out a link when I've explained to people that I need for them to give me the synopsis of what they're sending me so that I can in advance determine if I've already gotten the information. It just doesn't make any sense, people. And so we give instructions. In the last video, I said we're looking for people who have knowledge about lawsuits, doing lawsuits as pro se and as private attorney generals. We need people who have experience in debt elimination, dealing with debt collectors, anything in that field that they have prior experience. Then we also ask for people who, let's see, the lawsuits, debt consolidation, and I can't remember the other one. I have it written down, so I can't remember the other one right now because I'm not tired. I took some medication the last 2 days to get some rest and some sleep, so I am relaxed. But we told people that if they did not respond to us with specificity, we would simply block them. I had one person who did exactly what I asked. Not only did this person explain what their experience was, they also explained their research and how they researched certain things. Okay, they gave input about their knowledge of certain things. Even said they weren't hurting for employment, which is okay. Whether you're hurting for employment or not was not the issue. The fact is, we didn't want people talking about how they wanted to be a part of something and didn't qualify, because those were qualifications. Now, I know the video was 2 hours and 52 minutes long. Okay, that's because of the information it was covering, and we were covering lawsuits and we were covering responses. And basically, for your lawsuits, we put a lot of information in there which rebuts presumptions. So, once again, the last 15 to 20 minutes of the previous video, dated, I believe it was October 31st, 2012, tells you exactly what we're looking for, tells you exactly how to communicate with us, and it tells you exactly what you are supposed to provide in your email correspondence. If you can't follow simple instructions, then you do not qualify. That's just how simple it is. You see, you tell people that they are to walk a straight line and not deviate to the right or to the left. You guys were in elementary school where your teacher says, okay, I want everybody to stay in line. Stay in one line. Do not get out of line. If you get out of line, you're going to go to the back of the line. And how many kids did the teacher have to take out of line and put to the back of the line because they couldn't follow the simple instructions? Now, we do know that those instructions were just to program the children, you know, teach them. Like I tell you, elementary school, the very first thing you learn is your alphabets and your basic arithmetics. And then what do they teach you? They teach you social studies, how to get along in a group. Then when you go to junior high school, or what some of these people are calling middle school, what you learn to do is how to go to work. What do you mean go to work in middle school? Well, they send you to your first period, to your second period, which is your first job, and your first job requirements. Then they send you to your second job, and your second job has requirements, and then they let you take a break, a coffee break. In job phrase, that's called a cigarette break. And then after your cigarette break, you come back and you do one task, and then you do another task, and then they give you a lunch break. And after your lunch break, then you do two more tasks, and then you get to go home for the day, and your boss says, good work there, sonny. Good work. Okay, we'll see you tomorrow, okay, Bob? All right, Mr. Jenkins. Bob, he's a good worker. I like Bob. You know, I'm not too sure about his other workmates, Jimmy and John. Those two are troublemakers. And if Bob keeps hanging around them troublemakers, he'll never make it in the real world. So I'm going to have to keep an eye on Bob, and I'm going to have to caution him about his association.
Doesn't that remind you of work? Well, that's exactly what it is. And high school does the same thing. They are programming you for the job field. If you don't believe me, go back and look at how schools originally were. You didn't have first, second, and third periods. And you talked about all the subjects every day of the week.
All right. Let us continue, ladies and gentlemen. What the EFTs and the... Well, people are calling them EFTs, and I keep telling you that is the wrong phrase. But that's the only thing you all know because everybody did so many videos on EFTs. There is no such thing as a paper EFT. EFT says that it is electronic. If it is electronic, then that's what you're dealing with, an electronic instrument.
No, it can't be an electronic instrument. You just said if it's electronic, it cannot be.
That's exactly the point. Electronic means electronic. As you cannot see electricity,
oh, I can see lightning.
No, you can see it breaking the light barrier. You can see that, but you cannot see lightning. Electricity is invisible.
Well, what is the sparks?
Again, electricity moving so fast that you're able to see the aftermath after it has passed. But you cannot see electricity because electricity is everywhere.
You mean electricity is everywhere? Is it inside of me?
Yes, you have electricity inside of you. Without the electricity running through you, you would cease to exist.
There's electricity in plant life and animal life?
Yes, there is. As a matter of fact, there's a process called photosynthesis, which is definitely completely produced and processed by means of electricity.
So electricity is everywhere.
Electricity is everywhere.
So when they say electronic funds transfer, they're not really transferring funds. They're doing it electronically as if it's going through the computer.
Yes.
So that's not a good word for a process, because if it's going through computers, then there's no way for somebody to send something to someone through the mail, because that's not electronic.
Now you get it.
So what should we call it?
Well, I've come up with the phrase the closed checking account method.
Well, that sounds simple.
It is.
Well, can you tell me more?
Well, when you call it the closed checking account method, no one can be confused.
That's right. It doesn't sound confusing.
Yes. And then when you say to people that you're to write specific things on the item, that can be confusing.
Yes, you know, they told me do not do this, do not do that, must do this, must do that. That was all so confusing. I couldn't even understand why they were saying all of that.
That's why what we did is we told people that they needed to put one thing, two things, three things, seven different things on each item and send it to the different institutions. And you know what the institutions did?
No, they accepted them?
No, they didn't accept all of them.
Well, how was that working? How was that helping anybody?
Well, what they did is they literally told us. The music stopped. Hold on 1 second. Probably because there's a song that didn't play right. Let's go to the next one. What happened is that these wonderful facilities, they told us, they said, hey, y'all, just so y'all understand, because we don't get it and we want to get it, we're going to do it Earth, Wind, and Fire. Let's groove tonight. What they did is they said,
we will no longer accept items that says this and says that and says this and says that and says this and says that. Really? They said that? That's what they told us. They said, all that other junk, don't bring that to us. We're going to send it back with you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, because when I just said what I just said, it reminded me of Ice Age 4. And I'm not a big cartoon fan. I'm an anime person, but not cartoons. But I decided to watch Ice Age 4. Took me 2 days, but I watched it. And Grandma, played by Wanda Sykes? Let me tell you something. I'm not a big fan of Wanda Sykes' comedic abilities. But she played Grandma perfectly well.
okay? And I think of the whole so-called cartoon that she was the funniest character there, because some of the things you guys could just see exactly what was going on.
And I knew who Precious was going to be before the show even ended.
All right, let's...
Precious? Isn't that that woman who did that show and Oprah Winfrey produced it?
No, not that Precious. That's just a different Precious.
Well, they both look like the same character, so it must have been the same...
Hey, that's not right. Why would you even say something like that?
I don't know.
See, that's wrong. How could you say Precious the movie was anything like Precious the cartoon, that the two were... Oh, I get it. Oh, you're saying that both of them were the size? Oh, that's wrong. That is wrong. You take that back. All right, let's continue. We got the banks because that's what we were doing. We were manipulating them. And we could only have manipulated them with your help. See, we knew that many of you would not do the research. Sorry we had to manipulate you this way. But it was the only way to get them to show their hand. So there were hundreds of thousands of EFTs.
What they used to be called?
Closed checking account items sent to so many different institutions. Banks, counties, state, you name it. United States organizations, they were sending these things to everyone. Do not do this, do not do that, do not do this, do not do that, must do this, must do that, and credit this. And deposit this and all of these things, ladies and gentlemen. And because they received so much, they had to get a handle on things. So what did they do? Well, when they told us everything they didn't want on the items, that basically left everything that could go on the items. So we did a video. Did several videos showing people what we were putting on items and how much it worked. And... what we must insist that we have done is we've opened a doorway, a gateway. Now, you haven't heard us talking about the closed checking account method because, as I told y'all from day one, that was not my baby. I did not invent that. That was not my baby. So, ladies and gentlemen, we are missing one thing. So let me tell you what we're missing. On the top of the correspondence that you're receiving from banks and from corporations, you're receiving their name. Take a look. I'm looking at this letter from MTW.
McGinnis Testor Watcher.
Don't know. These are some stupid way to spell names, but this is MTW, and they are writing me in regards to a particular account. And it says, as you know, this particular group, I'm not saying the name, has previously provided you with extensive information and disclosure regarding the loan and debt referenced above. Nonetheless, please read the following carefully. This notice is intended only for the person to whom it is addressed. Please do not read or copy this notice if you are not that person. If you receive this notice in error, please notify our group immediately and return the notice as soon as possible. This law firm and its lawyers are not debt collectors, and this is not an attempt to collect any debt. However, any information obtained may be used for the purpose of collecting debts. As of October 15th, the amount of the loan due is blah, 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 and a copy of the payoff statement for this debt is included in this letter. It includes important information. Now, ladies and gentlemen, what they have done is they have taken a template that they have and they have sent the information to us through a template. Okay? According to them, the name of the current owner is Deutsche Bank as trustee. So how can they be trustee and owner? They are not the trustee. They're not the owner. Okay? Okay, what they're telling us is that their group has the right to enforce the note evidencing the debt and has the right to receive payment of debt on behalf of the owner of the debt. Who gave them that right? When I read the note, I find out that the only person giving any rights and privileges is the grantor. It's amazing how when you bring up that information to their attention, you get some act right. So basically, this law firm, and I love dealing with law firms because I get to highlight the law to these idiots. As a matter of fact, I have to scan this to the computer. I forgot. Okay. What I was going to get at with all of you is NWT is a copywritten notice.
What do you mean copywritten notice? Their name is at the top of the document, and that name is a copywritten name. Wait, what are you talking about?
Well, they put their corporation's name on the document.
Yeah,
well, that means it's their property, even though they sent it to you.
What are you talking about? How can that be their property and they send it to you?
Well, this is how it works, ladies and gentlemen, and I need you to pay attention. Pay close attention. They have copywritten their names. So anything with their name on it is their work product, their copywritten product. What you're not doing is you're not telling individuals. This is the wording that I created yesterday because it just came to me. On all of my instruments and letters from now on, it will say property of the RRO until negotiated and or processed. Now that's going to be on all of our instruments. Why? Because we have to take ownership of our stuff. My Windows Media Player has said it don't want to play no more, and I don't want to play with it no more. Okay? We have to take ownership of what's ours. If we invent it, if we create it, it's like a thought. If we invent it, if we create it, it's ours. It's not our owners, since the...
You guys know this song. This is Bon Jovi, or Jovi, or Jovi, or Hovi, or Hovi, John, or Bon Jovi.
You guys know Bon Jovi. Of course you do. Late 80s, early 90s, that was them. They were the... Well, anyway. Ladies and gentlemen, we need to start taking ownership of our stuff. So what I suggest in the footer of all of your doc...
What do you mean by footer? Is that like an Apple footer?
No, it's not like an Apple footer.
Then what is it?
Okay, hold on 1 second. I gotta find a document. Wait a minute. Going to do this right here. Yeah, this is something I was writing to Walmart. See? Walmart. Doing business as Walmart. Okay. When you are doing a Word document, let's say you just type in and you just type in and you just type in and you just type and then you just type and then you get rid of all of this typing and then you say, okay, I'm done. And then at the end of your typing, you do a salutation. Thank you, idiots, for all of your time. And then you sign it. Okay? All right. Now, what happens next? Well, it's down here in the footer. Double click on the bottom of the page. There's your footer. Then you type in, you idiots must understand this belongs to me and not to you. Okay? Just that simple. Property of whomever. And then you, look at that. Stays on the page. It comes on every single page. Just like debt collectors, when they send you something, this is an attempt to collect a debt. Any information received and or obtained will be used for that purposes. Okay? So, basically, do what they do. Don't do everything that they do because you don't want to be like them. That would be foolish. Foolish. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, our job, QuickTime Player. It says some of the file types in the QuickTime Players don't inform me again, and no. Okay. I don't want to see QuickTime. I didn't ask for QuickTime. All right. Let's finish, shall we? Ladies and gentlemen, what you're going to need to do is understand that their system is technical. They get technical on everything. So we're going to suggest that you get just as technical.
Technicolor? I remember when that came out.
No, I didn't say Technicolor. I said technical.
Well, no, Technicolor was a very good thing. They came up with it, I think, in the 50s. And it's like, you know, they could take movies and remaster them in the 80s and turn them into color. Like Gone with the Wind. Gone with the who? Gone with the Wind. Hey, we're not talking about fratulence here. No, not that type of wind. It's like, you know, you put a feather in the sky and the wind is blowing. You let it go and it goes with the wind. That's the going with the wind we're talking about. Oh, okay. I thought you were talking about the going with the wind when somebody sits on a pillow. You know, but I apologize. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. The Aurora! Thank you very, very much for your time. And we hope that we can continue to provide information to you that would be a benefit to you. And we hope that we can continue to provide relevant information. I have a lot of people coming at me saying, oh, and I found out this and I found out that. And they're not supporting it with any type of proof. But they're talking about it as if it's actual factual information. People, I don't want to hear that junk. Because that's not actual factual information. Unless you can support it by facts, then it is not relevant to anything. Facts. That's what we're relying on here is facts. We need facts.
Strictly the facts. Only the facts, ma'am.
Okay, y'all remember Dragnet. So let's stick to the facts. Oh, you want a fax? Well, no, you gotta first have access to a telephone line, and then you can fax anything you want.
Not that fax.
Well, that's what you said. You wanted fax.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, once again, thank you. Have a good morning, good evening, good night, good afternoon, good day. Have it all your way. Buenos dias, buenas noches. That's it. RedressRight.org, redress@redressucc.gmail.com,
and
on Skype at redress.right. Haven't been on Skype for a while, been preparing for this event. This is the last thing that I'm going to say. A lot of you have no idea the amount of work and research go behind preparing for an event like this. The amount of work, the amount of research, the amount of hours. And then not only is there a plane trip, but there's a road trip.
We're doing a road trip, Ice Cube style. Yeah.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, I cannot begin to tell you how much effort and how much time that the first 60 people at the event, all of that goes towards the rental of the event and the paying the individuals who are going to be there. And for the time. So in a way I see why some people charge $2,000, $3,000, although I still think that is too much. Okay, because they have food catered in, and I don't want to ever do an event where food is catered in and we have to pay per person for that catered food, because we have no idea on how good the food is, how the food tastes, because my taste buds isn't the same as yours. I kind of had my taste buds fried when I went through that operation. But I can still taste food, which is a good thing. Now let's do this.
Baby, I love my way.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, wait, I got to see who this is. I know who it is, but I'm trying to see if I can, remember. Well, I did not know it was Peter Frampton. I thought it was Elton John doing it with someone else, but it's Peter. All right. Let's continue. So, we have people complaining. And we know that the amount of the contribution, and it's a contribution, not payment, not even donation, that the amount of the contribution is what it is. We cannot avoid that because of the facility. And as we stated at the beginning, we are going to be allowing the recording of the event. Okay? We knew that some people were going to attempt to record it anyway. So, instead of us having to remove someone from the facility because they did something we asked them not to do, we're just now going to say we're going to allow it to avoid that as being a problem. Also, people don't have the same memory capability. So we're going to allow it so that they can have it, so they can recall it back. We will be issuing flash drives that will have pertinent information on the flash drive, as we've done before. These flash drives will run about anywhere from $20 to $27 each because of the information on it. Not because we're charging for information. No, we're not charging for information. These will be, I believe it will be about 8 gigabyte flash drives. And so that's the going price for them.
You sure the information is going to be 8 gigabytes worth?
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure that the information will be about 8 gigabytes worth. Okay? All right. And because we will be sharing software, we will not be giving software away. We will be sharing software that we have received that is freeware with people. It will take up some space on the disk, the drives, the flash drives. However, we will not be pirating. We will not be selling. We'll be giving gifts on these flash drives to people. Okay, ladies, gentlemen, ladies, we want to thank all of you. Ask that you all have a good day. And just remember, I love my way because I always want to get my way. All right, see you later.